Great entertainment, but it's also a chance for young people to get an appreciation of science.
It is indeed. Fox 40's Pedro Rivera live at Cosumnes Oaks High School in Elk Grove, where students are preparing for a robotics competition that will be featured at this weekend's air show. Pedro.
Oh yeah, Wolfpack Robotics has been working on this robot for quite some time. I want to show you it right here. It doesn't have any saws or anything. It's not going to destroy other competition, but it's going to beat the competition because it can do things like this, picking up the boxes, throwing the boxes. A lot of work went into this. Jason, you're one of the students here. You're a senior. How long it took you guys to put this together?
It took us a six-week build season, but we always improve upon our design.
Okay, so do you guys think you're going to win this weekend?
In terms of winning, it's a possibility depending on our alliance.
We're going to win.
Yeah,
we're going to win.
So you're going to win, man.
Yeah, we're going to win.
Okay, good answer. Better answer. Mr. Covert, he's the teacher here showing these kids how to do this fun stuff. STEM is a big thing, and I know this weekend at Mather Air Force Base, the California Air Show, they're having this robotics competition, a big focus on STEM.
Absolutely. You know, we have a huge deficiency in the number of engineers in America, and our students will go directly from this program into college. We have several that are already in the aerospace industry, and it's just a critical need for the country, so it's a perfect match.
Perfect. What can this robot do?
This robot can pick up these yellow cubes on the ground. It can also climb using a hook onto a pole. And it's got a lot of, it can elevate the cube as well. So it's got an arm that can articulate back and forth.
And it goes decently fast too,
right? It can go pretty fast. We rated it for about 15 feet per second when we were building it.
Let's see some speed. Let's get this thing really moving. All right, here we go. We're going to see how fast it can go. There you go. Don't crash into the bush. Okay. There you go. Now, for you, what is it like to see 6 weeks of work and finally see it come together like this?
It's the best thing ever. When you're working on something for so long and putting a lot of effort into it, seeing your final product is nothing can compare.
And it is a teamwork, I would imagine, it's a big thing. I see you have a big class, right?
Yeah, we've got a number of different sub-teams. We have, obviously, the mechanical team for doing the engineering. We have a software team. The kids write every line of code. They use Java. We also have the business team, the team that just sits there and writes grants. We're self-funded, so these guys will sit there and write grants, find grants, and apply for them and do presentations. We have a media team that does art to take care of all the artwork on the robot, make sure it looks nice, design T-shirts. So we're basically a small company, and the students do all of the work.
They do all the work. And what time are you guys going to be competing? Give us all that info.
We'll be there tomorrow night. I believe the doors open at 5:30, and then tomorrow or Saturday morning we'll be there from 8:30 till 7 o'clock.
Perfect. So if you are there and you're going to attend, make sure you look out for Team 3859 Wolfpack Robotics. They're going to be competing tomorrow, and hopefully they win, because that robot, it is pretty cool. I couldn't imagine doing anything like this myself. So a really impressive work by these kids here. But we'll send it back to you guys. I'm going to keep hanging out with this robot and seeing all that it can do.
That thing needs a basketball hoop
like
under it.
Get
some air under that. That's pretty good.
It's robot fighting time. That's pretty neat. 8:47 now at Fox 40.
Karma, all it needs is a Kings jersey, and we're good to go. That was fantastic.
And we've got some good robot fighting.